Hello everyone. In this video, let's look at creating of a Pareto chart. Logically speaking, a Pareto chart is more like the values plotted in the descending order along with the cumulative percentage of those values. The underlying principle behind this is an 80-20 principle, which simply says 80% of the effects come from 20% of the causes, or 80% of the work is contributed by 20% of the people, or 80% of the defects are found in 20% of the products. So applications wise, they have a lot of applications, and it has been proven in a lot of cases the 80-20 principle works pretty decently. So from that perspective, if I have a kind of a phenomenon where I can plot in that 80-20 kind of a chart on a dynamic way, it can really help me out, right? So that's where I thought I should use this data set to create the 80-20 principle or a Pareto chart. The reason why we are doing almost all the kind of charts on this on the single data set is just to give you a flavor of how much the data can be digged into inside to really create different kinds of analysis or look at the data from multiple dimensions. So in this, I have thought of a better example of, let's say, instead of a player-wise analysis, I would like to look at an year-wise analysis. So let me try to do a little bit on an year-wise. So I'll say year-wise analysis. So what I would like to do in this is, the moment, let's say, I select one year, let's say 2011, we can put that also in a drop down, but yeah, just for a simple understanding, let's say I select a year 2011, I want the system to identify who are the top contributors of 2011 and what proportion is contributed by the top 5, or what portion of the total runs is contributed by top 3, or how many have contributed the 80% of the total runs of the country. So there are lots of such analysis which I would be more interested in. So that's where I was looking at creating a Pareto chart, because these are the common kind of questions. Who has contributed the highest? Or who are the top 5 contributors? Or what is the percentage of work contributed by the top 5 people? So to answer all these things, I thought we can do a Pareto chart, which can really give, and that to doing it on a dynamic note. So the moment I change this from 2011 to 2010, the chart should automatically get updated for me. So, alright, let's look at that part of the chart. So, I'll go back to this run, because I need a year, whereas my data set has the dates. I thought a simpler way for me is to create another column called year from this data set, where I would use the year function of Excel to bring out the year corresponding to each, so that it becomes easier for me to really do an year-wise analysis. Then I want the total number of runs that are scored by each of these players in the selected year. So that's where the summary numbers, I would like to use this sheet where the list of all the players has been given. I would like to find out how many runs they have scored in that selected year, let's say 2011. So, runs in selected year, I'll put one. Here, I can use the help of our SUMIFS formula again, because I would like to find out the total runs this person has scored in 2011, whatever was the year that was selected. So, that's where I'm using the SUMIFS function. The first one is what I need to sum. I want to sum up the runs, so I select the C column. Then the criteria is the player name should be equal to the name of the person whom I am of that first row. So the player column is being selected. then that should be equal to the name of this player. So like that, for each of the players I would like to go with. Then the year, so that's where I use this column. Year is equal to the selected year. This is what will bring in the dynamicness for us. So that's where I'll put the dollar by pressing F4. So doing this, what happens is I would get the total runs this person has scored in a particular year, in that 2011. So I can drag it down and I would see somewhere at the bottom that this person has scored 513 runs in this year. Then there is this person with 124 and so on. Now what I should require to do is, for a Pareto chart, the first important stuff is I want my data in the descending order. So that's where I'll have to set my data. So all I will do for that purpose is I'll find, let's say, the top 20 or top 30 contributors, assuming there will not be more than that. Let's say top 25 or top 30 contributors. So 1, 2, I require the top 30 people, and that too in the descending order. And I just want to use the simple formula. So that's where large is a formula which will solve this purpose for me. So I'll say large in this array, select the first largest. So within that particular location, find out what is the first highest value. Then I will find out the second highest, third highest, and so on. So the first highest is 1381. Probably if I scroll down, I should be able to see 1381 somewhere down. Yeah, there is a 1381 here. So that is what this large as a formula will give. In that particular selected region, the first highest, second highest. Now when I drag it down, I will get the second highest, third highest, fourth highest, and so on. Alright, but now I require the name of the person corresponding to it. Or, even before I go towards that, I require to add up these total runs. So that's where I'll simply say sum of all these. Alright, I have added using a sum, so there is 8008 as a total of all these. And also I require who is this person. So, to find out who is the person matching for a particular number, I can use a combination of index and a match function. Now, if you are comfortable using the Excel formulas of index and match, that is fine. Or even if you are not fine, I'll do it as a step-by-step process. First, I'll find out in which row of my data this 1381 is present. So, for that, I can use the match function. I'll say simply match. So, look up for this 1381 in this entire column and give me the row number. So, I'll do an exact match and ask the system to give me in which row that 1381 is present. So, it has given me 176. You see, there is a 176th row where this number is matching. So, then corresponding to this number, I want the first column element, which is the name of the person. Corresponding to this row, I want the A column element, which can be actually obtained through the index function. So, on the top of this, I'll simply write index where, so 176th row is what I require of this A column. Of this A column, return the 176th row, whatever is the element. So that is what it will return, V Kohli, which is the person who is present in 176th row. So corresponding to the largest value, first largest value, this is the person corresponding to the first largest value. Then I can drag him down. You see that there are different people who have scored this differently in that particular selected year. Alright, now the next part for me is, the numbers are already sorted in the descending order. So, I will say, I'll call these as runs, I'll call these as players, then I also require in the cumulative runs. So, for which I would, for the first one, I would simply take as it is, but from the next, I would simply add up the previous total with the current number. And so, which means these two put together, the first and the second put together, have contributed close to 2145 runs. Then if I drag it down, this is what, these are the, so the until the last put together, 8000 runs. So now I can convert this into percentage by dividing this number. So let me call this as cumulative percentage. So let me divide this number by the total. So total I would put a dollar. So yeah, this is what is the cumulative percentage, which means one person, the first person alone contributed to the total of those many runs. So probably I would like to put it into a percentage with zero decimals. So the first person contributed 17% of the total. The first two contributed to 27%. And probably the top 9 contributed to almost 80% of the runs. Right, so the only the top 9 or probably top 7 have contributed to the 67%. So, we can really make out what is the proportion contribution, proportionate contribution by each of the players or by the top 3 performers, top 5 performers during this particular year. Alright, so now here there could be one problem with our index and match. For example, let me try this out. Let me change this from 2011 to 2010. What I would see is, everything looks fine apart from this stuff. If the total run scored is the same, the index and match combination will always retrieve the same person. Though there might be two people with this kind of. So, actually speaking, there are 218s in our data. Probably if I go here, I should be able to find 218s. One is with AB Dinda. And there would be other 18. There would be other 18 somewhere else. There is Zahir Khan. So, both of them have 18, but when I was using index and match, it will always retrieve the first element corresponding to the match. So, how do I resolve that kind of a problem? So, there are multiple ways, there are a lot of foolproof ways of doing it, but I would slightly try to design a simpler but not that, simpler to work out. And easier way to do, but not that advisable in case of a very important data set. What I am typically trying to do here is I would like to create a very minute difference in the values. So for that, I am thinking of just adding a very minute number like 0.00001 multiplied by the row number. Now, in this case, what happens is, I am multiplying, so the because for each of the data, the row number is different, multiplying that row number with a very minute value will increase the value, will create a difference with respect to the other value, but a very minute difference, so the order may not be disturbed by adding this very minute value. So, You see, this instead of 0, now this becomes 0.00002 and so on. But this is not our original data. The data should be 0 itself. So, here I would like to handle it at the formatting layer. I will simply handle it at a formatting layer where I will simply put it as a number with 0. It's only a format, only the look and feel. I'm changing it so that it becomes 0. But internally, the number is actually 349.000000 something. That is done to create a difference here, a little bit of difference in the order. Now, even this number actually now is 995 as a part of the presentation. But actually, this is 995.000 something. So, I tried to handle it here by changing the format of that. Now, you see, though there are two 18s, we see that two different players are visible here. Even though there are two 1s, two different players are visible here. So, that makes my data more clean for doing this kind of a plotting. Alright, now coming back, my intention is to plot the Pareto chart. Alright, so what I would simply like to do is, I'll select this data, probably the entire data. And I would simply put a column graph. Alright, this is the kind of a column graph that is getting generated for us. Cool. And along with this column, actually runs are not included in this. So, let me even add up. So, I'll select this chart, select data. Do an add where I would add up the runs in the title, and in the series values I would like to add up this series. Okay, even the runs have got added to this, but yeah, I really don't need cumulative amount. I'll try to use only the cumulative percentage instead of cumulative amount, because I want it more in terms of what percentage of the total runs are contributed by the top 3, top 5 kind of a people. Alright. So, which means again I'll go back to the data. I don't need cumulative runs. So, I'll select this and I'll delete it. So, only these two. There's a green line that is showing in a descending order. But one thing is the cumulative percentage is not visible. And even the runs, they are showing in terms of percentage. Right? So, I can very well edit that part by changing the format of that presentation. I'll do a format. Instead of percentage, I'll make it as general. The moment I make it general, I see that only the numbers are being shown. Alright, so that axis is adjusted a little bit. And one more thing I require here is I need the cumulative percentage, which is not being visible. So, what I would like to do for that is, I will take the cumulative percentage, because it's very small, 71% is nothing but 0.71, whereas this is 440, and which means the vertical axis, the vertical y axis represented on the left hand side is a very large value. I'm not able to trace the cumulative percent because all these numbers are very much less than 1. They are becoming very difficult to be traceable. So that's where the suggested scenario is. Try to take it on to a parallel axis, create a secondary axis. So, what I would do is, I'll select the chart. Once I select the chart, I get this chart tools bar, wherein I select the layout tab, get into that series of cumulative percentage. So you see that something gets selected on the chart, go to that, right click on it, do a format data series, and you say that you plot it on a secondary axis. The moment you do it, you see that a separate kind of a curve got created and a different axis got created on the right hand side. That is what is the plotting. But the other disadvantageous part is we see that both the curves are getting overlapped. The green as well as the red, both of them are getting overlapped. So to avoid that kind of a overlap, the item that I am plotting on the secondary axis, I'll change the chart type of that to a line, probably with a marker. Now we see that the graph that is coming out is much more easy to understand. So we see that there are 6-7 people contributing to the 80% and all the remaining guys are contributing to the remaining 20%. But yes, here what is getting missed out is the x-axis. I'm seeing that the numbers are being shown on the x-axis. So that's where probably I need to again do a select data. Instead of having the numbers on the x-axis, I need to make them equal to these names itself. Alright, so I am getting the names on the x-axis. Then, one more step which I require to make this chart more interesting is, probably I can remove these grid lines. Alright, I am deleting these grid lines. I don't need this stuff, so I'll delete this. Now you see that the graph is slightly much bigger. And you can very well, if required, you would like to plot, let's say, the 80% line or something. We can even add one more column for that. But otherwise, these things probably we can reduce their fonts. We can reduce their fonts so that everything would be visible. And even these fonts we can reduce a little bit. So such kind of changes can very well be done. Alright. Then, I can keep both the axes. And one more thing I can think of is, now I can remove the chart background, so I'll make it to no fill, so which will make my chart completely on a no background. So what I can very well do is, now I'll carry this chart onto my dashboard page, where I would like to put up this entire area colored exclusively for that dashboard. Alright, I'll select this area for that dashboard purpose, and at the top I would simply specify player wise performance in the year. Alright, so I'm calling this as player wise performance in the year, making this bold, making this underlined or bordered, And even if required, I can even change the heading of, probably I would change the heading and even the font color. So we can very well play around. So using the Excel formatting becomes more easy in terms of representation. So what I would bring is, I'll cut this chart and bring it into this location. So I'll paste the chart on the top of this location, slightly trying to adjust the size of this chart. I got the size of my chart. Yeah, I don't need even this plot area, so I would make the plot, set the plot area also to a no-fill so that I get the background. And yeah, the colors are not looking that attractive. So what I can do is, I can do a control 1, change the format of these colors. Let's say I would use a violet. And probably for this, I would like to use probably a red color itself, both for the line as well as for the marker. Yeah, so this this one I can simply make it slightly more lesser in size so that it comes more vertically aligned, or probably I can even say vertical text or rotate text upward. So that will push my data a little bit and it will give me the required Pareto chart, which will be useful for comparing the top 5 players' performance or any number. So this would, and probably I can keep the marker size slightly lesser because the data is looking so big. The marker is, so I'll go to the marker options and I'll say a built-in marker of this with the size just around 2. That would reduce the size of the marker considerably. So one way I can try to reduce the cluttering of the data. And if required, if I would like to plot even one more line talking about the top five contribution or top 7 contribution, something like that, we can very well create one or two more extra lines and we can plot it onto the graph. But yeah, as of now it says, okay, if I want for a 80% contribution, if I put my cursor here on this graph, it will show me, yeah, up to this person the contribution is around 82%. Up to the previous the contribution is around 77%, and so on. So that way I can make the Pareto chart look more and more interesting. And yeah, we'll try to have some mechanism where we can write something onto this chart to make the it more and more meaningful. So the runs, yeah, I require that on the left hand side there are the runs and player wise and the percentage wise contribution. Yes. And this axis, probably I can change the label of this axis, because the percentage may not exceed 100 at any point. So that's where I can change this to 1, so that a slight more clarity will come into the graph. Alright, so we need to actually use the location and the space more effectively. So we have some space here, we have some space here. We'll try to see how we utilize the space to generate the better result. So this is all about the Pareto chart, just to test it out. Change it from 2010 to 2011. We need to see that our data should change, or probably 2009. The data should change accordingly, which is what is happening. And yeah, let's do something more. Let's even add the top 5 people contribution. Top 5 country. Just to make it even more. So the top 5 always is corresponding to the 5th. So what I would do is equal to that. And after this, I'll keep it as it is. Okay, this is what is the top 5 contribution, which means I come to this sheet. The other way I can do is, I select this data. Copy. Come here, select on the sheet, and do a simple paste. So this will directly give me, yeah, whatever was the last sheet that was selected. So what I can do is I can make it a line chart without any kind of markers. So I would simply put a straight line chart, and probably with a slightly better color, which says that is what is the contribution of the total 5 players. Alright, so I'll make it, let's say, black or something. And let me try to put it with some kind of dashes. These dashes are not visible properly. So let me again select this data. Yeah, if I select slightly lesser, that is what is looking much better. So now now we see that there is a line. So which means the top 5 people are contributing, let's say, to the 62. We will write something. This is what is the line corresponding to the top 5 people contribution and all. We'll try to write something on the graph slightly later as a part of some of our other videos. But at this moment, I'm just bringing in the additional data, which would tell me what is the contribution of the top 5 people. So at least 60 plus is the contribution of the top 5 people here in 2009. But when I move to 2010, that number comes down to 60%. So some kind of a basic analysis can definitely be done. In 2011, it's still more further. Or probably if I look at 2012, the top 5 contribution is phenomenal. Almost close to 80%. So we can really evaluate from this kind of a data what is the contribution of the top few people in the team. I hope this gives you a detailed insight into the creation of a Pareto chart. Thanks a lot for listening to this video. Thank you very much.